By the beginning of 1943 came the Gestapo, the secret police, which was created about 2 months after Hitler took over. And they told us, in a few days, get your things ready, you will be brought to Berlin. We're going to evacuate you to east, back east. And they came after 2-3 days, and we had to fill out a little slip, if I remember right. Since I'm a traitor or spy against Germany, I have no business to live within the German border, and I will be evacuated back east somewhere. And there were some couples with little children, and a father or mother to sign for the child, my son, daughter, baby, 6 months old, 3 months old, it's a spy or traitor against Germany, and the father to sign the slip for the child. So we lost our, to say, our citizenship because...
Did you sign?
I had to sign. We had to sign them. So we were taken to Berlin. That was a formerly old age home. It was Große Hamburger Straße, I remember. And we stayed there for 2-3 days. Oh, no, maybe a week, let's say. And after 3-4 days came two men with shorn hair, and they were caught. They said, you don't have to bring nothing to the camps. You lose everything you own. We said, well, what do you know? Maybe you lost everything. We take our stuff along. For us, it's different. We are different. Those were people who escaped from Auschwitz, and we didn't believe them. They tried to tell us things, but we didn't have much time to listen to. It's just stories. Come on, just give us a bunch of baloney. We don't believe that. And we take our things along. So, well, we didn't disregard what they said.
What did you take with you?
We had, like I said, 2 suitcases and a backpack each. And we put on 3-4 jackets or whatever, just to keep as much as possible. So on the 19th of April 1943, a day before Hitler's birthday, which was on the 20th, some big shot must have sent a note to Hitler. As a birthday present, we sent a big transport going east. So they took us to a lonely train station on the 19th, and they took about 60, 70, 80 Jewish men, women, children in an empty cattle car. There was some straw on the floor and one pail to relieve yourself. And they shut the door, and here we were going into the unknown. We were told, well, you men, you work on a farm here. You have to take the farmers over now in the east because you have to go to the different fronts, the German farmers. And you, Wim, you can work in the factories, making uniforms for the army, uniforms for the party. And we believed him. I mean, whether we're ignorant or gullible, I don't know. Anyhow, what's the difference, working here or working there? But after a day or two, when we arrived and they opened the cattle cars and we looked out.
Can you estimate how many people were in that car with you?
I would say 50, 60, something like that. We half sitting, half laying on a floor, there's no seats.
About were you given any food or water?
No, nothing. We just shoved us in. We figured we'd get something on the way, you know. No, we didn't get anything. We were just, but we were too excited. We figured, my goodness, what are they going to do with that? We had nothing to, unless you had some own provisions, but maybe you had something in your own pocket.
Were there any windows?
Yes, the tiny little window way on top of the cattle car. Just to let air in, little air, with some bars. Once in a while, two guys got on top of each other to look out, or the train stopped somewhere, and somebody took somebody on the back, take a look, where are we, you know? And we didn't know. We went in to the unknown, so to say. And on the 20th, by the way, on the way to Auschwitz, the Warsaw ghetto uprising started on the 19th of April 43, and we didn't even know about it. That was the same time when we were riding in a cattle car to Auschwitz. So they opened the cattle cars, and we looked out. Here we were surrounded by barbed wire, as prisoners running around back and forth with a striped uniform, and the Nazi guards, the guards, SS guards with the German shepherds came into the cattle car. Come on, that's not a resort. Get out here. Hurry up. Come, let's get going. And there were some older people in the cattle cars. He said, wait a minute, I have to grab my suitcase. Forget about your suitcase. You can get that later on. And they rushed us and pushed us to a big field. In fact, I got some pictures. And they put us in a big field, or I don't know how big it is, the whole transport. In all that mess, there was one man staying on a little podium, and with a flip on his hand, he sorted people out, who shall live and who shall die. He shouted, young men on one side, young women on one side, women with children, women without children, old men, old women, he sorted everybody out. And the older people were told, now you must be tired from the trip, why don't you go over there to the hall and take a shower and change your shirts, whatever you have. And there were some older people who said, oh my goodness, we can walk that long, that's too much. Oh, don't worry about it. So they brought some trucks over to load the people on the trucks to bring them over, I don't know how far, to take them to the so-called showers. And we, the younger people, we were taken, I was good enough, I was 22 at the time, I looked good enough to the Nazis, and we were taken on the trucks and brought to Auschwitz III.
Were you with your wife at this time?
We were together until we arrived in Auschwitz-Birkenau, and as soon as we arrived, when the men shouted, we were separated. In fact, I saw something my wife didn't see, otherwise she wouldn't have made it. There was a woman with two children, little children, and one on the arm, and the children, the little one, was crying, and my wife tried to help the woman with a child. Give me one of the children, I hold your children. But when I saw there was a difference between women with children on one side and women without children, I shouted in the last minute to my wife, give that child back. There's something going on. My wife looked at me, what's the matter with him? And she gave the child back. Otherwise, my wife would have put away like anybody else. Nobody with children ever saw the camp. The older people and mostly women with children just put away.